So, because basic concept is the Bayes theorem, and that is very, very important, means Bayes theorem. So, to understand Bayes theorem or to derive the formula of Bayes theorem, we need to discuss some of the basic concept of Bayes theorem. The first is the partition of the sample space. So, what will be the definition of partition of a sample space? Sample space is a set. Sample space is a set. If I will discuss this thing in general, then it is better to say that partition of a set. Correct? Because here we are taking the partition of a sample space. So, it should not be like that. Means only we can make the partition of sample space. We can make the partition of any set. Correct? So, what will be the partition of the sample space here? Let a set of, means let us suppose we have set of events. What are the events? E1, E2, and so on up to EN. And you know that all the events are set itself also. Yes or no? Means all the events are set also. Is it okay? Correct. So is set to be set of all the events. If you will collect all the events, it is named as a set, and is said to be a partition of the sample space S if number one condition means intersection of any two events EI or EJ, intersection of any two events will be phi always. Means intersection will be empty, must be empty. I and J must be different, and I and J will be from 1, 2 up to N. Because the maximum highest value of the IJ will be N. Because we have a collection of E1, E2 and so on EN. This is the first condition. Means if you will take any event out of these two events, out of the collection, so intersection must be phi. Number two, if you will take the union of all the events, E1 union, E2 union, E3 union, so on up to EN, it must be equal to S. So if these two conditions are satisfied, and the second will be in probability of any event will be always greater than 0. Here means here you can take EI, means E1, E2, E3, probability of any of the event must be greater than 0. So why this third point is there? We will not include those events whose probability is 0, because it will not affect. Okay, we will take only those events whose probability is positive, means some value. Okay. So theorem, once again I am revising, theorem on total probability will be, if you will take E1, E2, E3 are the partition, already we have explained about the partition. So we will take, this is a sample space, whole sample space, is it okay? Now, so I am taking the partition means E1, E2, E3, E4, E5 and so on up to EN. Correct? And nothing will be common between any two events. Already you are aware about this. What is the meaning of a partition? Means intersection of any two events will be phi. So if you want to take any other set, because this partition already has covered the whole sample space, nothing is left, no element of the left of set S is left other than this partition. Means all the elements has covered by these partitions. So if you want to take any other set A, it must be some of the element of E1, E2 will be shared with A. So our target is, if let us suppose if you will take A intersection E1, A intersection E1, A intersection E2, A intersection E3, A intersection E4, if you will take all these separate and they will be disjoint, And when you will take the union of all this, means sab kuch so on, union of all these, you will get again A. Okay, and one very important thing, all these sets are disjoint. Nothing is common between these sets. So you know that the probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. This formula is applicable when probability of A intersection B will be phi or 0. And when it will be 0, when A and B are disjoint. So if you will take the probability of A here, it will be the probability of whole this, and all these are disjoint set, then it will be probability of this plus probability of this plus probability of this plus probability of this. Now, by using the concept of probability of A intersection E1, condition probability concept, then it will be probability of E1 into probability of A oblique E1. I will substitute the value of each. A intersection E1 will be this, A intersection E2 will be this, A intersection E3 will be this, and so on, A intersection EN will be this. So this formula will complete the probability of A will be sum of all these probability. This is the total probability theorem. Correct? Students, just first you must know the basic statement of the Bayes theorem. So you must write with me. If you have E1, E2, when you will write, the things will be in your mind. So try to write it. Don't see it. Write it. If E1, E2, comma, so on up to EN are the all non-empty, it is important, non-empty, non-empty events, also known as partitions of sample space S. Okay, means it is very clear when it is given, means S will be is equal to E1 union E2 union so on up to EN. Yes or no? And no two intersection of EI with EJ will be phi for I not is equal to J, and I comma J will be 1, 2, epsilon, N. Then the probability of any of the event oblique A will be is equal to probability of that event multiply probability of A oblique that event divided by summation J is equal to 1 to N probability of EJ into probability of A oblique EJ. This is the theorem. What is the proof of this theorem? And you know that by conditional probability, you know that if you have any event EI oblique A, if you want to find out this, then what will be the formula? A intersection EI divided by probability of A. Is it okay? And we have proved the total probability of A in the previous. So what you will write? So what is this? This is this one. By using multiplicative theorem, probability of A intersection E will be probability of EI into probability of A oblique EI. Is it okay? And what it will be? This will be probability of ei e1 probability of a oblique e1 plus probability of e2 divided by probability of a oblique e2 plus so on probability of en into probability of a oblique en, and hence prove. So this summation is, we have written like this, this one. Is it okay?
Yes.
So this is the proof element. Now we have question number 1. We have R1 is the, let the red ball is drawn in the first time, because we have a two situation. We have 5 balls, 5 red ball and 5 black ball. Correct? So the situation is, when you will take one first ball is drawn from the box, so it may be red, it may be black, and when you will draw the first ball, you will note down the color. When you will note down the color, whatever the color is noted, you will put two more additional ball in the box of the same color, and draw the one more ball from the box, and we want to get the probability of red ball in the second draw. So what we are going to take, let's R1 is the red ball drawn in the first time, and B1 is the black ball drawn in the first time. Then we want to get probability of R1 will be 5 by 10, because we have 5 red and total ball is 10. 5 over 10 means 1 by 2, and probability of black ball is 1 by 2, same. And if you want to, because our requirement is probability of red ball. So probability of red ball when second red ball. So when first red ball, it will be, because when you have a first red ball and you will put more red ball, so you have a total 7 red ball, so 7 over 12. But if you have a first black ball and then second red ball, then total ball red balls will be 5 and total balls are 12, so 5 over 12. So total, by total probability theorem that we have explained today, so it will be probability of R2 will be probability of R1 into probability of R2 oblique R1 plus probability of B2 into probability of R2 oblique B1. You will substitute all these value and you will get the final answer. Question number 2, we have 4 red ball and 4 black ball. Okay, another ball contain 2 red ball. This is the bag one, and this is the bag two. We have 2 red ball and 6 black ball. It's okay. One of the 2 bag is selected at random, means first we will select the bag, okay, and then a ball drawn from the bag which is found to be red. Means first you will select a ball bag out of 2 bags, and after that you will draw a ball from the bag, and when you have taken it out, then that ball is found to be red, means it is a red ball. Find the probability that ball drawn from the first bag, means when ball is red and it is from the first ball, this is the situation of Bayes theorem.
Yes.
Correct? You have 2 bags. First I am taking E1 as an event, selected bag 1, and E2 event, selected bag 2. You tell me, what is the probability of E1? What will be probability of E1? Is 1 by 2, because you have 2 bags. 1 is selected. What is the probability of E2? 1 by 2. Is it okay? So we got the probability of E1 and E2. Now we are getting the R is the event, the ball is drawn ball is red, means whatever the ball is drawn out of the bag, it is red. It is the event R. You can say, even that we have discussed in the previous Bayes theorem, you can take it as a A also. Is it okay? Now what do you need? What do you need? You want to get the probability of even probability of A, probability of A oblique even, and you want to get probability of A oblique E2. Is it okay? So what will the probability of A oblique even? When event E is happened, so you have selected bag 1 and total balls in red balls are 8, and how many red? 4. Result will be 1/2. Now when you selected second bag, so total balls are 8 and how many red? 2. It is 1/4, and you want to get probability of E1, and you want to get it should be from the first bag, means E1 when ball is red. So according to the Bayes theorem, it will be probability of E1 into probability of A oblique E1 divided by probability of E1 into probability of A oblique E1 plus probability of E2 into probability of A oblique E2. Are you understanding?
Yes.
Now substitute the value. Substitute the value. Here you have a 1/2 into 1/2 into 1/2 into 1/2 plus 1/2 into 1/4. So you have 1/4 in the numerator. Here you have a 1/4 plus 1/8. So you have 1/4. And here you have, if you will take LCM 8, you have a 2 plus 1. So what you have? You have 1/4 divided by 3/8. So when you will solve further, you will get 1/4 into 8/3. So you will get 2/3. So this is the answer of your question. I hope you understand.